Assalamu alaikum. We are standing here while 100 years went past since the Balfour Declaration, the document that gave the first governmental legitimacy to the movement of Zionism. Thank you. Pro-Zionists are celebrating this day as a great achievement, and they consider this the cornerstone of the State of Israel. But we need to remember that Lord Balfour, in his declaration, offered his support on condition. As he wrote in his declaration, it being clearly understood that nothing should be done, that nothing should be done which may prejudice the civil and religious rights of existing non-Jewish communities in Palestine. And he adds, or the rights and political status enjoyed by Jews in any other country. Now, this Balfour Declaration was not unconditional. Balfour understood that this might cause a catastrophe not only to the non-Jewish inhabitants of the Holy Land, but the Jewish people as well. And he wanted to prevent all of this. Other British politicians opposed this declaration. They believed that this indeed will prejudice other people and will lead to conflict and catastrophe. Religious Jewish leaders also did not accept this Balfour Declaration. They warned that this can get to a very bad situation and get all peoples in trouble. And they went even a step further. They said that even if Balfour's condition will be fulfilled, and even if other people would not be oppressed, and even if there will be peace, according to basics of Judaism, this is forbidden, because Jewish people are in exile. This is basics of Judaism, and Jewish people are forbidden to create a state of their own. Therefore, these religious Jews in the Holy Land and elsewhere rejected the Balfour Declaration. The Balfour Declaration was not the first time in history in the past 2,000 years where Jewish people were offered a sovereign homeland. Just one example took place in 1826, where an American journalist, Mr. Noah, purchased land on an island next to Buffalo, New York, with the plan of building a sovereign place for Jews. He sent letters to the chief rabbi of England and of France to ask them to come and lead this Jewish community in this new sovereign land. And what was the response? The response was no. This is not a Jewish tradition. This is not in accordance to our teachings. Jews are forbidden to end exile by physical means. We are to be peaceful, loyal citizens in the countries where we reside. This is how Jewish people did conduct themselves for centuries, and this is how we are supposed to. And the Jewish leaders expressed their fear to what can be the result of this Balfour Declaration, of this declaring a homeland, a Jewish homeland in Palestine. Especially after decades went past and the reality became a fact that other people were oppressed. Conflict did begin, and unfortunately we experienced bloodshed to the present day. We believe that Lord Balfour's intention was a good one. He was about to help Jewish people that were oppressed for so long, but in no way he intended to bring catastrophe upon other people. We appreciate Lord Balfour's good intention, but unfortunately we see today that what Balfour was afraid of, what other politicians predicted, what Jewish leaders warned. Unfortunately, this became a reality. And it happens to be, in reality, the state of Israel is in no way a favor for the Jewish people. Yes, it might be a movement of nationalism that might favor some politicians and this political movement, but in no way we can say that this is in favor of Jewish people. A blatant violation of Judaism, of the Jewish religion, cannot be considered in favor of the Jewish people. This destruction of peace that did exist in the Holy Land between all peoples of different religions and different races, and all of this was destroyed just because of this political movement of Zionism, cannot be considered in favor of the Jewish people. Jews throughout the world face hatred because the actions of the state of Israel that is supposedly being done in our name. It might not be, not everybody is aware of what is happening in the Holy Land for decades, and especially recently. We have here two colleagues of mine joining me today who came from Jerusalem. They bear witness to what is going on already for decades, how the state of Israel is not only is run by people who not only violate everything within the Jewish religion, but they attempt to uproot Jewish religion from all other Jews. This is a systematic oppression of religion that is taking place, especially recently when the government of Israel is attempting to force all youth to join their army. And we did never do so, and we will never, despite all hardships this Israeli government imposes upon our people. People are imprisoned, people are beaten for refusing to serve in the army or for standing up and protesting this new legislation. Presently now, if I'm not mistaken, 45 young people are imprisoned. This is besides all others that were already released after long terms. The state of Israel is trampling on the human rights of everyone, including the Jewish people. The state of Israel violates our freedom of religion. We should have a freedom of religion to practice our religion freely, as we have here in Canada, as we have in the United States of America, or in any other democratic or even religious country. They grant freedom of religion to a group who wants to serve Almighty God. And this is besides all other catastrophes they are imposing upon the Palestinian people. It is about time to understand that the Zionist movement, the Israeli spokespeople, do not represent the Jewish people, neither in the time of Balfour or in our present time today. Judaism is a religion only, the service of the Almighty. Versus Zionism, this political movement is just about nationalism and drops everything holy. The Jewish people are those who practice the Jewish religion. The state of Israel is a nationalistic movement. It's a Zionist state and is not a Jewish state. It should never be referred as a Jewish state. It is about time to wake up and to understand, teach others that we have to stop this prejudice, we have to stop this occupation, we have to stop this bloodshed, we have to stop this conflict for the favor of the Palestinian people, for the Jewish people living in the Holy Land, and for humanity. We pray for the speedy and peaceful dismantlement of this political movement of Zionism, which is behind this political state of Israel, once these obstacles to peace will stop, we can expect to see once again that peace, that beautiful peace that did exist in the Holy Land prior to all this nightmare, prior to all this conflict. And we should see once again this peace and harmony, to be able, all of us, to serve Almighty God together. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum.
Free Palestine!
Free Palestine!
Free Palestine!
Free Palestine!
Down, down, Israel!
Down, down, Israel!
Down, down, Israel!
Down, down, Israel!
Free Palestine!
Free Palestine!
Viva Palestina!
Viva Palestina!
Viva Palestina!
Viva Palestina!
1, 2, 3, 4!
1, 2, 3, 4!
State of Israel no more!
State of Israel no more! 5, 6, 6.